Don't sleep with your phone.
Yeah. Don't play with the batteries.
Worrying about artificial intelligence will take over and so on is a little bit too early, and in most of cases is not justified.
I believe in the near future all the electronics will be the charged wireless. Hello, my name is Aishwak. I'm a postdoctoral scholar at the School of Engineering and Digital Science. So I have been working there almost 2 years. And my research interest is in the batteries, so development of the materials for the batteries, so they improve, they enhance the performance, and etc.
Hi, my name is Martin Lukak. I'm associate professor in computer science. I've been at Nazarbayev University for 7 years. And my interests are quantum computing, emergent computing technologies, artificial intelligence, and different levels of learning and algorithm optimizations.
Could you explain what is AI and ML and how they works?
The general idea is that artificial intelligence is the largest area of essentially tools, research, and methodology about trying to make computers intelligent, solving problems for us, and by whatever means. So inside we would have logic, we will have inference, we will have deductive learning, we will have inductive learning, and so on. After that, one of the subclass of artificial intelligence is machine learning, which is concerned about letting machine learn something from some data. So, for example, let's say that you walk across the crossroad, and you will be walking randomly across the crossroad, and every now and then you will get hit by a car. Yes. Mm-hmm. And if you observe the environment, you will see that every time you can get hit by a car, the sign is red, and when you don't get hit by a car, it's green. And so the general idea of learning is that you learn to associate that when it's green, I'm going to get hit by the car. When it's red, I don't. I get hit by the car. So essentially, from observations, generalizing the knowledge. And the deep learning, that's a subclass of machine learning. And it is specifically related to in the most common term, to a distributed approach to machine learning, such that you have, many layers of input transformations until obtaining some output, and it is mostly non-explicit knowledge. It is distributed, and most of the times we actually don't know what is happening there. Yes. How is it about the myth that sleeping with a cell phone can affect or can disrupt your sleep, or does it have any effect on the human organism?
If you look at the outside of the battery, there is a label, the warning about the catching fire, mm-hmm, and the possibility of the burning. So this is happens because of the not stable materials inside the battery. Mm-hmm. So especially at the charge state, this cathode materials, especially so-called the NMC, mm-hmm, they are not stable. Mm-hmm. So if there is some side reactions, then it could explode.
Okay.
So, right. So therefore, to be in the safe side, it's better to keep the phone a bit, at least a meter away.
I see. Yeah, from you. Well, don't sleep with your phone.
Yeah.
Why is it dangerous? What should be aware about in batteries?
Mm. So the mostly used one, lately used one, is the lithium-ion batteries.
Yeah.
They are widely used because of their high energy density. Mm-hmm. So compared to the alkaline-ion batteries or the non-rechargeable batteries. So they, as I mentioned before, the materials inside the battery is not stable. Also, in addition, the electrolyte inside, mm-hmm, there is an electrolyte inside the battery. It's made of organic solvent. This, mm-hmm, organic solvent is flammable, also toxic. So we have seen many videos where the batteries are catching fires and burning. Mm-hmm. This is because of the leakage of the electrolyte. So, mm-hmm, so I would suggest people not to disassemble or cut or don't play with the batteries, even though it's the dead battery, I mean the not working battery, but still we don't need to play, we shouldn't play with the batteries because it could harm you.
Because I remember when I was in Japan in 2011 during the big earthquake, they had a problem that, what do they have, that was the Toyota Prius, yes, the hybrid cars. Some of the cars who were flooded, they essentially ended up exploding and the batteries were turning on fire.
Yeah, because this, the electrolyte is sensitive to the moisture, also the when they contact with the water, there is a like, huge see. Reaction happens and it's explosion, it explodes. Now people like using AI to do something and to do their jobs. And do you think in the future the AI will replace the human?
Well, I hope so. On the other hand, we have the super idealistic of Star Trek. Yes, I don't know if any of you saw Star Trek, it is so old that I don't even remember it. But the general idea was that the society was so advanced that everybody could do whatever they want. Right. So, and in this sense means, oh, if you want to go and pursue the study of stars or whatever, you can, because, and you can concentrate only on that because everything has been, you know, everything is sort of taken care of. Now, of course, as it will go with humanity, it will be somewhere in the middle. You know, we will have people who will be very happy not doing anything. We will have people who will be using this thing. Now, how far it is, you know. How did this evolve? Is it still how much energy is lost? Is it a viable technology? Is it has been developed, or what is the advances in this in the wireless charging?
In the future, I believe the since there are many research going on this direction, so in, I believe in the near future, the all the electronics will be the charged wireless. The, we have heard about the dark AI, so I'm wondering what is it.
We have everything from what do you have? We have spying. We have the deep fakes. We have. I presume that right now I'm not completely expert in the security or the safety or the privacy things, but you can very much imagine that in the future, you, instead of doing a manual DDoS attack, you can have an AI. More advanced virus that will go and hack a bunch of computers and do things on that, right? Yeah. In addition, it is possible that the dark AI, depending on the, I would say, state of the evolution and development, will go and be located in the dark web, which is the illegal side of the internet or the non-monitored side of the internet, and then there can be various things that could happen, yes? What can you tell us? What would be the correct way how to use batteries? Right.
If you have the cars, you have lead acid batteries in your car, and if you turn on the lamps and leave it, and in the morning, you come and you cannot start your car because of dead battery. In that case, the reaction happens, and after like certain point, the reaction is not reversible, so you cannot go back. You need extra. Energy to pursue this reaction, but in lithium-ion batteries there is no such problem. But it's recommended that if you don't need to charge fully, as I mentioned in the first question, that the cathode materials are not stable, especially if they are at the charge state. So if you fully charge, the material is not stable. So if you don't charge it fully, let's say around 80%, then you can prolong the life of the battery. AIs can read the emotions, do you think?
You know, we are working on recognizing facial emotion from, in particular, Asian faces, because Asian faces are the most difficult. You know, we have a data set for white people, black people, some other people, but when you come to Asians, it becomes quite difficult because Asian express, especially if you go to Japanese, they are absolutely, you know, it doesn't work. So again, recognizing facial emotion is one thing, understanding emotions is another thing. Are actually the current electric cars better for environment than the top of the line, how is it called, combustion engine cars?
We make the batteries from the raw materials, from the minerals. So is it same like digging the oils from the earth and also the the minerals from for the batteries? But in both cases, the side effects I believe in the batteries are less compared to the oil. Mostly right now, mostly EVs are powered by the lithium-ion batteries, mm-hmm. but the lithium resources are limited. So it's available only in a few places in Earth, so in the South America mm-hmm. and China and Russia. So in near future, the price of these resources could be controlled. I'm working on sodium ion batteries, so sodium ion batteries can be made from the salts, mm-hmm. table mm-hmm. salts. We see many when you check the YouTube, you see many people are there wants to discover what is inside the battery and they want to know. But I would advise you to not to open. In the early 90s, we used to have this non-rechargeable batteries, right? When it's dead, when it's not working, we used to bite them and it started working. But it's the principle of this battery and the cat batteries that we are currently using are different. So you shouldn't be biting this lithium-ion batteries because it could harm you.
For the safety, I think it's too late. by default, if you live in a city or so on, just learn to live with it, or throw away your cell phone, your credit cards, and everything. So I mean, for the privacy, yes. But I mean. I think for the more imminent threats, you know, such as we talk about this dark AI, somebody will come and steal your money and so on, I would say, you know, it's a standard awareness.